Rascal, You Overdid It Doll by the Cortinas. You can download this on the 14th of February. The album's called Falcon, which is going to be out on the 22nd of February.
BBC Radio 1's review show with Nihal.
Idris. Cortinas.
It was...
Oh, that was a long...
Honestly, listen, I was listening to this and I was just like waiting for something to really just get me involved, get me hooked, you know what I mean? It reminded me of... what did we say? It was just, it just reminded me of like 80s music, and then it, the instrumentation and the production of it was all right. It wasn't too bad, but it just didn't do anything, didn't go anywhere. And then I kept thinking, I had to look at a piece of paper. Is he saying you overdid it though? Or you overdid it dull?
As in, you get me dull?
Yeah.
Right.
Now, I was hoping he was saying you overdid it dull, because I was like, all right, well...
And then the Hackney in you came out, I went, oh, okay, I like it
a little bit more, but... No, I have to say, it was a little bland for me, but 50%.
50%, all right. Reggie.
Oh, you're a
give me
man.
A percentage first, so
yeah,
I don't feel.
I was going to say, I was going straight in with that knee. How I know the rules. You're definitely a kind man, because I gave it 35, and I wasn't massively into it. They had a song in 2008 or 2009 called "No, You Didn't Know You Don't," I think, something like that. And that was much more interesting. It was much more fun, much more upbeat. It was used all over telly, and I really liked that record. Whereas this just kind of. It's a sort of record that could be on at volume 5 or volume 50 and you still feel exactly the same way about it. It doesn't grab you. Mm. And if I interview him, oh, it's not going to be pretty.
I'd turn the volume down if I was
there
you.
There you go. Bottom line is, it just didn't really grab me, so
35%. 35. Yeah. Camilla, is this the kind of music you would naturally gravitate towards or run a mile from?
It was neither, really. I agree with the other guys that it was just... nothing, just somewhere in the middle. I also scored it 50 because I just thought it's not 100, it's just 50.
Which I think is actually quite generous, because music should emotionally touch you, and if it fails to do that, then that should actually deserve a much lower score, to be honest. I think you've both been very kind.
Well, yeah.
There's something in it that sounds a little bit like Franz Ferdinand. I think he's trying to sound like Morrissey. I know they've always used the Smiths producers.
Morrissey. But you got the M right with Mitchell, but couldn't be wider apart, really.
But it's not as good as Morrissey. So there's no real point to it, I think. Yeah. I just don't see why they really put this record out.
Right, okay.
What's well, the worst maybe you could give them?
Yeah, isn't it?
I don't understand why you put it out.
Why? Oh,
can you imagine that? Come out of the studio, Camilla walks past. Excuse me, lads, why'd you bother? You've been doing something else. here's a nice book. Read it.
Well, the new album, they might have some stronger stuff on it.
Right. Well, Falcon, the album's out on the 22nd of February. Final percentage rating, I don't think anyone would be surprised to know, isn't high. 45%.
That's fair, isn't it?
45%. I mean, you know. Guys, veering around. Audio ambivalence, I think, is probably how that can be described. All right, let's move on to a Serbian producer and DJ called Marko Milicevic. Okay, so you'd think that Marko Milicevic might pick an easier name to pronounce as his artist name, but no. Gramophonesy is not Gramophonevic. Gramophonesy is what you want. This track is called Why Don't You. 81199 is the text. I'm going to play a minute or so of it. The track's called, as I said, Why Don't You. Just check it out, see what you think about it, and then afterwards we'll come back and find out what Reggie Yates thinks about it. Sipping champagne at Pasha, you may be listening to Gramophonesy with Why Don't You?
BBC Radio 1's review show.
With P. Diddy and Diego Maradona in the VIP section. There's a night out. You know what I mean? There's a night out. Anyway, Reggie, what did you make of Gramophonesy?
I feel like
are
a bit
Pete
of...
Pete Tong about this, or is it all Pete Tong?
Yeah, I think it's all Pete Tong for me. I feel a bit bad, because I'm the only one sort of being really mean about these records. There's always one,
no,
isn't there?
No, you're not on this one.
Because I'm not alone.
We already know what Camilla's going with this. All right, Reggie, go.
Well, do you know what it is? The thing that kind of got me about this record is that... what they've tried to achieve has been done before, but much better. I think Mint Royale did exactly the same thing with Singing in the Rain, but did it a lot better, and it was a much bigger record, and this just sort of feels like a bit of a wet version of that. Doesn't feel particularly interesting. It's got a bit of a bump to it, but not enough to excite me.
Okay.
Just okay for me. Percentage, I gave it 35.
Oh,
it's gone in harsh.
Come on.
So you liked it? You
oh, sure? No, wait there, no, wait there. No, wait, sure. Let's go to Camilla. Okay. Because Camilla, we have a similar vibe going on between Camilla and Reggie with regards to this track.
Yeah, I didn't like it at all either. It really reminds me of that track Dupe that was number one in the early 90s, about 94. And it just wasn't doing anything different. I hated how it went between the beat and the sample. It just jarred for me. I think the beat's great. I think you could get into it, but then as soon as the sample was coming in, I was just like, oh. Wow. So I don't want to not like it, but I'm afraid I gave it 10.
You should have seen Idris' face with the 10. Oh my gosh.
Oh, I don't know where to start, man, because I take on both your points. I think I definitely think that, they could have, there have been records similar that have been better produced, but as soon as I played it, man, it was just bumping in the car and it just took me elsewhere. And, I'm a fan of it reminded me of the garage, UK garage, where, all that sort of chopped up sample stuff was evident. And it also reminded me of, you remember when, drum and bass records would drop into the sample, complete, take big portions of the sample and then bring the beat back. Yeah. Yes, it wasn't grimy, It was quite a clean sound. But
so
I also
were you into
like
the
that.
Arrangement? Because what you're talking about is that you love the way the arrangement, and what you're thinking about is how it worked for you in a club. As opposed to listening to it in this context.
Yeah, if I was in the club now, or I was DJing this tune, I'd put this in my set for sure, because it just has that clean feel to it, It's going to grab everyone's attention, and you can, mess around with it, the beat and the bass and all that, so...
Percentage-wise?
Yeah, man, I 85%.
Come on!
I'm sorry.
Are you sure?
Hey, yeah, I like that record.
Are they paying you?
Come on.
Gramophonesy, your pal.
That's my bridging, Gramophonesy,
Gramophonesy.
I tell you Idris is raving in Serbia all the time. He's just insured himself a plus one in every guest list in Belgrade for the next 10
years. Yeah, but 85% is high compared to how you've broken it down, but I loved it. Yeah, man, I was bumping to that today.
Cool.
Maybe the car's the place to play it. Maybe we're doing it wrong.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Okay.